वेलकम टू केम्स पार्क, अ सिंपल प्लेस फॉर ऑल लेवल ऑफ केमिस्ट्री. दिस टाइम आई फॉर सेकेंड पार्ट आई गॉट डिलेड बिकॉज आई एम नॉट गेटिंग टाइम. सो टुडे आई मेड अ मेक सेकेंड पार्ट वीडियो. सो इन दिस नाउ वी विल डिस्कस रिमेनिंग पार्ट सी क्वेश्चंस ऑफ सी एस एन जून 19. सो हियर यू कैन सी दिस एग्जाम्पल वी विल डिस्कस फर्स्ट. सो दिस इज बेसिकली दिस रिएक्शन इज स्टीरियो सिलेक्टिव एल्डोल कंडेंसेशन. ओके, सो वी विल फॉर्म हियर फर्स्ट इनोलेट. Here boron reagent is there, so boron enolate. Here lithium enolate. Okay, so as you can see here, I have written this reaction. LDA with this will form cis enolate, and this will form with this boron component will form trans enolate. And one major shortcut trick is there. Shortcut trick for stereoselective aldol is that if you have cis enolate, you will get syn aldol. If you have trans enolate, you will get enolate. This is fixed. And syn and LT, how we have to identify? See this, both methyl and OH groups are syn. These methyl and OH groups are trans. Okay, like this you have to identify syn and LT. So this is syn aldol, this is anti aldol product. So now we'll discuss first reaction. So this is stereoselective, means two product we will getting. This is not asymmetric synthesis. Okay, asymmetric aldol is different and stereoselective aldol is different. Both are different. In stereoselective you have even have two product, two diastereomer you have. And in asymmetric, you have only one enantiomer or diastereomer, you can say. So here you can see, you have starting material, this phenyl ethyl ketone. So when we at LDA, this is the acidic proton, this will get removed and this will form enolate. So when we will get this cis enolate, whenever this group is bulky, like phenyl or tertiary butyl, that time methyl cannot accommodate with this, they will have repulsion. Suppose If you have like this, so they will repel each other. So methyl will go upside, opposite to this phenyl. So this will, you will get cis enolate. Like if you compare this, this is the first priority between this and this, and here hydrogen is then priority is this. So this is cis enolate or Z enolate, both are same. So this is stereoselective enolate. After cis and trans, we get one enolate. So in second case, similarly, this is there. Now the triethylamine is the base and boron is the reagent. So boron will first attach here, triethylamine, then remove this proton. Okay, then this enolate get formed. Now here also, see, as you can see here, if it is a boron butyl reagent, then also you will get similar situation, because this is also cyclohexyl is also bulky group. Butyl long chain is also bulky group. So here, whenever you have this butyl or cyclohexyl, you have methyl at this position, opposite to this. But whenever you have like BBN compound, boron bicyclononane, like whenever you have BBN compound, that time methyl is shifted upside, because it is a 3D molecule, it will have some less repulsion. As you can see from here also, I have separately have written here. See, whenever you have this BBN kind of compound, or not this, this is something different. See, whenever you have this butyl group, say in this example, whenever you have this ketone and butyl group, this methyl go upside. Similarly, when you have this cyclohexyl group, this will felt repulsion and this will go down. Okay, so butyl also, we can say butyl is a smaller group, but cyclohexyl is a bigger group, so methyl will feel more repulsion here, so it will shifted to this position, methyl. Similarly, whenever you have this, whenever if you have this also group, then also this will feel less repulsion, so this also come above the plane, above side, not plane, above side it will come. So out of these three boron, whenever you have this only we have the cyclohexyl, the time of this methyl is shifted to down position, not with this as well as not for this. So this is basically transenolate. As you can see, we will get first priority here, and out of this first priority we will give to this methyl. So we will get this transenolate. Because in stereoselective aldol, this is only very important, cis and transenolate formation. Once you will get, then you can easily select the product. So here we can say, so this is a cis enolate first example here, and our starting our substrate, second substrate is ethyl propanaldehyde, ethyl CHO. So ethyl CHO. Here I have drawn this TS. This TS is 6-membered chair form. This is known as Zimmermann-Traxler transition state or model Okay, so here we will get this syn kind of product. As you can make out from here, I have drawn ethyl CHO in this position, and this is a transition state I have drawn like this. See, this ethyl group is always at this position, equatorial position, because if it is this position, you will get this ethyl and phenyl repulsion. So this will prefer syn aldol you will get here. Okay, so these both are syn product. So whenever you have C-synolate, you will end up in getting syn aldol. This, and again what I have said earlier, that this is a stereoselective, means both options are possible, both options are right for this, both are syn. Because now in second case you have this transenolate, this is the transenolate. So transenolate will give us anti-aldol, and this OH and this methyl also right option, this methyl and this OH also right option, both are possible because this is a stereoselective, not asymmetric. Okay, so from option we can make out that, see, this A is C-synolate, you will get this syn-aldol product, and B is transenolate, you will get this anti-aldol product. So this is all the right option. Now, very simple question, earlier also asked this kind of question. Now another question which we discuss now is this is continuation of Ireland collision, electrophilic and then syn-elimination. See, first in LHMDS and TMS collider knitting, this will take place, Ireland collision rearrangement, 3-3 sigma tropic, then electrophilic attack, and then elimination of that. See, so first step is LHMDS is there. LHMDS is a strong base like LDA, which is a very strong base. This will remove this acidic proton, this will form this enolate first. Then you have TMS chloride. TMS chloride, you can say it's a bulky proton like this. This is a bulky proton for using for more selective. So this O minus will attack at this silicon, this chloride will remove. Okay, now you have this arrangement of 3-3 sigma tropic, like you can make out from this. You can label this allylic oxygen, this allylic carbon. So 1 2 3 1 2 3, so 3-3 sigma tropic will get formed. Sigma, new sigma bond is forming at 3-3, that's why it's known as sigma tropic under heating condition. So this will transfer here. Again, this is cyclic TS, the mechanism you can see. This is also cyclic transition state will form. You will end up in getting this product. Now in this case, you have this phenyl silyl chloride. I have separated it, I have heterolytically fissioned it, SiP plus and Cl minus. So Cl minus is more negative, that's why I prepared negative charge here. So here, what I have shown here, I have break this molecule, this reagent, Cl minus attack at this silicon, this will shift to here, this will carry O minus now. So this O minus will, it will carry O minus. Now here you have two probability that this oxygen will attack at this internal site. This is known as phi exotric from Baldwin rule, which is commonly more favorable. So as you can see, this is 1 2 3 4, and this oxygen will form fifth bond with this. So you will get this, you are end up in getting this 5-membered ring. When it attack at this position, this will become CH2 minus, as you can make out here. Another possibility is that if it attacks at this end carbon, if it attacks at end carbon, this is known as, see, now you will make a 1 2 3 4 5, and this will form sixth bond here. So this is known as sixth, it will come, this electron density is coming inside, so it is known as endotrig. Endo means inside, trig means trigonal. This is, both are sp2 hybridization, that's why it's called a trigonal. And if attached at this, and electron density coming out of the ring, it is known as exo. Okay, so exo means outside electron density, endo means inside electron density attack, and trigonal means this sp2 hybridization. Okay, so this both position are, both product are possible. But when you see the carbon anion stability, that time you will end up in getting this as a major product. And when you, and another possibility, when you do 6 endotrig, you will get this carbon which is less stable compared to this. Okay, so then after this, once anion is formed, we have this electrophile. pH Se plus is electrophile, so it will get attached to here. So as you can see, now we have anion. Okay, so this will attack at this electrophile, as well as this will attack at this electrophile. Here also you will get two options, SEPH. Then finally H2O2, this will, the H2O2, when you add H2O2, it will form this selenium having an electron pair, it's a sulfur family. It will attack this oxygen, when oxygen from H2 to it will take, it will form like this bond, selenium oxide, or double bond also you can show, as well as this Sc plus O minus equals and so. Now you have seen elimination, but stereochemistry is not important in this case. So this H2, this selenium oxide elimination is a seen elimination. So here this alpha and beta elimination will take place. So beta hydrogen from this hydrogen will get removed. This double bond is formed here. You will get here phenyl SeOH as a byproduct. Whenever here beta hydrogen is this, you will end up in getting double bond here, and this is your byproduct. So most probably I think this is the major, but let's CSL answer key come, then we will decide which is the final answer. Because every time when you see the CSL answer paper, question paper, 2-3 questions are confusing. We have confusing between two options. Otherwise this exam were very easy if it don't confuse you. See, now this is the next question. So earlier I have not mentioned this. So the right option is between this or this, but most probably I think this is the right option. Let us see as the answer key comes. Then we have this another question. This is simple question. This is simple. There is no confusion between them. So this is the question. You have this ketone, LDA, again methyl silyl chloride, then ozonolysis, reductive ozonolysis. Okay. So as you can see here, this is the starting material I have taken, then LDA. So now LDA is a bulky base. LDA is a bulky base. It will form kinetic enolate. Okay. What is meant by kinetic enolate? I have made separate video on enolate. You can watch that in a separate video on my channel, on Chemspire channel, for on enolate. This thermodynamic kinetic enolate, you will find out that. So here you can see there are two types of proton. This is also the proton. This is also acidic. Both are acidic proton. But which is more acidic proton? As you can see, this is more acidic, I am saying, because this is less crowded also, but that is not the reason. But main reason is that here it is not connected with any methyl group. See, this is methyl group. So once you have this anion and this anion is less stable. This anion is more stable because this is not connected to this methyl plus I effect. This will not have methyl plus I effect like this. So this is, and this already have electron density, so this is less acidic proton. So more acidic proton is this. But when you say the most stable enolate, so that time this enolate is more stable compared to this enolate. Okay, but again this is thermodynamic enolate, this is thermodynamic, and this is kinetic enolate. So once enolate is forming faster, that time we are saying it is a kinetic control or rate control, and whenever enolate is forming stable, that time it is a thermodynamic control or equilibrium control. In LDA we are always getting kinetic enolate. So this is our, we have no other options. So this H will get removed, this will form enolate here, and once it becomes O minus, then TMS chloride comes, then electrophile nucleophile attack will take place, it will form OTMS. Now we have important step, ozonolysis. So first is ozonolysis will take place. So we know that ozonolysis is used for double bond cleavage, double bond fission or double bond cleavage. Okay, so this will cleave from this double bond, cleaving from this position, this double bond, you will end up in getting this as an CHO product first, then COOTMS here like this. And when you use NaBH4, okay, when you use NaBH4, now reduction will take place. So this aldehyde will become alcohol, primary alcohol. This, as when we know that acid don't have any effect on NaBH4, don't have any effect on acid group, okay, or TMS ester group. So now finally NaBH4 is this OH converted into CHO, and this also get reduced. So this will become OH. Now you have 1 degree alcohol and acid. So acid and alcohol is forming, acid plus alcohol is giving us ester, and this is cyclized, so it is known as lactone. We will get lactone as a product. So the H2 will get removed, and this will form ester. So this is only our right option. So we have option, we left only with this option. So this is the right option, we don't have any other option. this when we'll make this ester, when we have removed this proton, but we know that kinetic energy is forming at this position only. Now another reaction, it's a Willsmer-Haack reaction. So in Willsmer-Haack reaction, let me check that Willsmer-Haack. I think it's here. Yeah. See here what they have mentioned. This starting metal with this DMF POCl3 one equivalent and DMF POCl3 excess. So this is one equivalent. So first we will discuss that why we are using Willsmer-Haack reaction. This is for formylation reaction. We are introducing our formyl group into our moiety. Okay. So whenever you have one equivalent of DMF POCl3, you will first we will discuss how what is the main electrophile in Willsmer-Haack reaction. So as you can make out here, this is a DMF dimethyl formamide POCl3. Now here this will go into resonance, this oxygen will attack at this position, it will go O-. So it will become now trigonal bipyramidal and this will carry positive charge now. This will become sp2. Okay. Now when this oxygen shift their lone pair to phosphorus, this Cl- getting removed. Okay. Now this Cl- is the Cl- which is getting removed, it is attaching at this carbon and this will getting neutralized as you can see here. Okay. Now again this lone pair will attack at this carbon and this bulky group is going as a leaving group. As you can see, this is a leaving group. So this is the main reagent in Willsmer reagent. This is also known as Willsmer reagent or main electrophile of this reagent. So now we have competition between equivalents. So whenever you have one equivalent, we know that indole ring is more electron donating than furan ring. As you can see, this is less nitrogen here. Plus R effect is dominating here, minus R effect is dominating, as same as case in pyrrol. When you compare between pyrrol and furan, pyrrol is more donating. Similarly, indole is more donating. So here, when you have one equivalent of DMA POCl3, here only formulation will take place on indole ring. When you have excess, you don't have any option here. So this is worst. This is benzene and this is furan. So furan is, this is benzene, there is a benzene and furan. And you already have one CHO group, so it now become withdrawing. So now indole ring will become withdrawing. So you have only one option, furan. And we know that furan reactivity is, electrophilic reaction will take place at 2 and 5 position. So 5 position is blocked at here, so 2 position only left. So CHO is getting introduced here. Okay, so here I have just shown mechanism also how this is attacking place. So this, as you can see here, it will resonance and this will attack at this. This will getting neutralized. Then re-aromatization will take place. Then finally you will end up in getting this iminium salt. Then iminium hydrolysis will give you CHO. It is aminogen byproduct. It is more related to like Mannish reaction. And in Mannish reaction also you have such kind of electrophile, imine electrophile. Now this is Billy-Silman reaction, very the pioneer synthetic chemist of this reaction is in our India, University of Hyderabad. In University of Hyderabad there is one professor, I think now it is retired, Basaviha professor. He is a very pioneer synthetic chemist of India for doing Billy-Silman reaction. He have so many review also on Billy-Silman reaction, you can refer on online. Around I remember that he have one review, around 120 page review on chemical review. Then we have this but we will focus now on this question. So the major product, this is the substrate diabenol and DAPCO. Whenever you have DAPCO as a catalyst, so DAPCO catalyst we are using in Billy-Silman reaction. Okay, so as you can see here, you have this substrate and this DAPCO reagent. So we will search the main specialty of this reaction is that we are able to do alpha alkylation on enone moiety. So as you can see, this is enone ester, so you have this alpha and beta, so we can do alkylation at this alpha position. Okay, but I will turn on the light. Now in this exam, now we will continue. Sorry for disturbance. So see, this we have ester, okay, and we have this DAPCO as a catalyst. DAPCO as a catalyst reagent. This is basically tertiary amine, the 3-degree amine basically. So I have represented this R3N only, because it's very difficult to draw again this weak structure. So this will attack this. This is conjugate addition. First step of this mechanism is conjugate addition. So nucleophile attack at here, it will go under resonance. Once it will come to this, then you have to this, the beta position is blocked. So this double bond attack at this electrophilic carbon from alpha position. So this is the main step, alpha alkylation. Your alpha alkylation will form. Then you have again this catalyst as a base. So this H is getting removed, and here you can see this anion is getting formed, and this is a conjugate base. So here it is, elimination is like even CB. This elimination is like even CB. Anion is forming, and this is a withdrawing group. Okay, so this anion is getting stabilized. Then this electron will come here, and this leaving group goes out, and you can reuse it. So this is the even CB elimination. This is the alpha alkylation. This is, two steps are important. Now we can again reuse this amine. Now here you have this OH group. This CHO will convert to this OH group. Then finally, you have this Dabco as in. So here, see here, double bond is also getting formed. So okay, this is now become again ester. Only alpha alkylation will take place. Now in second step, where we use benzylamine. So benzylamine is a, then that step is a Michael addition. So as you can see here, this benzylamine will attack at this. I can say 1, 2, 3, 4 addition. 1,4 addition will take place, and this is the Michael addition product. Okay, so in this reaction, there is a two type of reaction, Bailey-Schillmann as well as Michael addition. So right option is this only. We are left with this option only. Okay. Now we'll discuss spectroscopy question, NMR question. Very interesting question they have asked this time, but very easy also same time. So as you can see here, the IR, they have given data 1685. I have written actually already. So see, IR data is 1685 centimeter inverse, which is whenever CHO, whenever carbonyl group is attached to plus R group or plus I group, that time the standard carbonyl value is 1720. But whenever you have plus R or plus I group, it will decrease to around 1680, and whenever you have minus R or minus I group, it will increase to increase to 1740 or so on. Okay, so this is 1685. That means we have carbonyl group is conjugated. You can say carbonyl group is conjugated. Okay, this is the data we have. So carbonyl group is conjugated, then proton NMR, you can see. So see, first we will discuss this here only. From IR data also, what we can conclude. See, the COCl value is coming around 1800. So we can directly neglect this option from IR itself. Okay. And top of that, see now, this bromine is not conjugated with this electron. This bromine lone pair is not conjugated with this electron, if we consider resonance effect of this. Okay. And this is a standard carbonyl group, so it will not show even that much decrease in frequency also. As I mentioned here, it is standard value 1720, so this will come around 1720 itself. So from IR itself, we can cancel out these two options. Okay, now we have proton NMR. So in proton NMR, we have five peaks in proton NMR. Okay, 7.84 J value. As you can see, this J value, both J value are same. That means these both hydrogen are connected to each other, adjacent connected to each other, and these three all have same coupling constant J value. That means all three are adjacent to each other. So from J value, how we can conclude that this aromatic adjacency, both are adjacent to each other, and here three CH2 are there. All these are adjacent to each other. So from J value, we cannot make out, because all two are common. Okay, or there is a tough competition between 1 and 2. Then we have now chemical shift. So chemical shift, we can say 7.84 and 7.6. Okay, so in this 7.84 is correspond to 7.84 correspond to this withdrawing group is there. So this is 7.84, is also 7.84, and the other is you have 7.6. So this can be 7.6. This can, we cannot conclude from this data chemical shift. Then you have 3.65 triplet, 3.18, and 2.25 pentate. all three are adjacent to each other. So one which is connected to chlorine, this CH2 is more deshielded than this bromine, because we know that chlorine is more electronegative. But here it's very tough to mention chemical shift data from chemical shift. So from proton NMR also we can conclude that we have this two peaks in aromatic region. So here we have in this fourth option you will have this four peaks. So here from this proton NMR also we can cancel out this fourth option. So again we have not solved this problem between this one and two. Now from carbon NMR, as you can see this value, but carbon NMR also, just a minute, carbon NMR also, carbon NMR also we cannot use that much. So we left off with mass only. So mass is the deciding factor now. So see, as you can see, at 198 it is showing 1:1 peak. That means this is a pattern for bromine. So and see, now this is whatever will the stable fragment of this mass with bromine is always attached to this ring. That's why it is showing 1:1 peak here. Okay, then after removal of 198, after removal of one CH2 group also, it is showing 185 and 183, and both are in 1:1 ratio. That means bromine is still there in this aromatic nucleus. So from this we can make out that first option is the right option. So mass is the deciding factor to selecting between 1 and 2. Otherwise, if you know directly chemical shift, you can make out, but we cannot remember this much chemical shift. So from mass is a clear indication that first is the right option because of this isotopic abundance. We have 1:1 ratio peaks in mass, we have always 1:1 peak. So this is not getting removed from this aromatic nucleus. If you have this chlorine, the ratio is 3:1. Okay, so one is the right option from mass we have concluded. Now another spectroscopy question is very simple. This question for us for 5 minutes, they have mentioned that reaction of styrene with HBr will give you two products. One is major and one is minor, and we know that this is the major because of stable carbocation. This will be Markovnikov rule, we can say. Markovnikov rule, if you apply, this is the major product. Then they have given in peaks. So this 5.17 correspond to, I will mention this here, A, B, C, D. So 5.17 correspond to this most deshielding because of aromatic paramagnetic effect as well as this bromine minus bromine electronegative effect. Then this 6 means this B less deshielded. Then you have C and D. C and B, between this B and C, this bromine is directly connected to this proton. So this will show B type chemicals. B, I can label this B proton. Here is a C proton. Okay. Now check out the ratio, integration ratio. This means 6. 6 means this is the 6 time 5.17. This is 2. That is means this is the ratio of 1:3. Okay. Now here B and C both are 1:1 ratio. Okay. Now if you take molar ratio of A and B, total we have this 2 and 8 proton, 8, or you can say 8 centimeter integration ratio, and this is 2 centimeter integration ratio. Area means, integration ratio means area. So here you have 4:1 as in ratio, molar ratio. So our right option is 2. This is a very simple question asked from NMR. So 4:1 is the right option. Then this is the question asked from degradation of terpenol. Normally in MSc we have this syllabus. So this is a monoterpene they have mentioned here. Monoterpene means 10 carbon containing compound. So here all are 10 carbon containing compound. So we cannot make out from here this option, because sometime what happened between mono and diterpene, if you have option you can select monoterpene, but here all are monoterpenes. So we have this dilute KMnO4. Dilute KMnO4 means it's a Bayer's reagent. Okay, Bayer's reagent only able to do oxidative addition. Oxidative addition means diol formation. So this double bond is get, that will form diol. Okay, then ClO3 if you used, then this is getting oxidative cleavage. ClO3 is oxidative cleavage will take place. This will first convert to CO. K ketone group, and this is converted to first aldehyde, then it will first convert to aldehyde. Then if you have CrO3, it will further convert to acid. So this is acid is forming. Now this OH and this OH getting condensed, that means electron is getting formed. So this is electron is forming, 5 membered electron, as you can make out here, 1 membered, 2 membered, 3 membered, 4, and this is finally 5 after losing of water. Here you will get 5 membered ring. So as you can see, 5 membered ring you will get from here. And here they have mentioned keto lactone, you will get keto lactone. Okay, so keto lactone, this is ketone group and this is lactone group. Okay, now I have drawn. Okay, now what I have done in next time, in then you have the option, they have given alkaline kaminophore and heat. This is the very strong kaminophore condition. This is the mild kaminophore condition. Here only you have oxidative addition. Okay, but this is alkaline kaminophore heat or acid kaminophore heat. It is a very strong condition. Here we get oxidative cleavage. Oxidative cleavage will take place. So I have drawn here enol form. So most stable enol form is this only. So I have drawn this keto form, keto enol form. I have drawn here this enol form of this keto group. Now we have KMnO4, NaOH, and heating. This is the, again what I mentioned, oxidative cleavage will take place. So this will break from this double bond, and you end up in first step is diol formation, then this simple oxidative addition. But we have strong condition, it will take cleavage also. So this will get, this bond is getting break here. You will end up in getting this CH2 and this acid group. First is aldehyde, then is acid is forming. So this here are getting acid, and this will also give us acid, this acetic acid, but they have not mentioned here. So the acetic acid, and here you have this option. Okay, so out of this, now the question comes, why have directly selected this third option? Because if you draw this, if you break from oxidative cleavage of this side or this side, you never get this end product. So we have directly selected this product, but you can try yourself and start cleavage, then we will not end up in getting this product. Okay, now this is the protection deprotection question. Another question is protection deprotection. This nitrobenzyl alcohol used for protection of ester, so this is basically photolytic deprotection step. So once this ester is there, so once that that if you introduce light, then this will go homolysis. I have shown here homolysis mechanism, and ultimately I have started balancing. See this, now this hydrogen is getting removed. So the position of this 1, 2, 3, 4.